Well, it all started because of our interest in the health benefits of having natural light that occurs at the right time of day that helps regulate our circadian clock and our mood and our alertness. In certain places, like where it's gloomy outside a lot, like in Seattle, there's lots of people that suffer from seasonal affective disorder. And there's just all sorts of problems of living under artificial lights all the time where we're just not as happy and healthy as we hope we would be. It's known that there is a particular cell inside of our eye that communicates with the parts of our brain that are responsible for these fantastic effects of light. And so one effect is that, you know, it synchronizes our internal biological clock, so it's working properly with our activities. The cones in our eye that are responsible for color vision also send a color signal to the same cell that goes to those same centers, but it wasn't very well understood. And so our idea was to try to understand this better, and if we could understand how the cell works, then we could use that in order to better figure out different kinds of light solutions that might solve some of our problems. And ultimately, you know, the original satellites that have been proven to help people with depression are super bright. They're hundreds of times brighter than normal lights that we use, like at our desk or something like that. And they're very expensive and they're heavy, and then people were supposed to stare at the super bright light, and that works. But we're thinking about the fact that maybe just the regular lights that people have in their office or their room, or get up in their bathroom in the morning and get some good light that's going to be healthy for you. In the real world, it's the light overhead that we're using to see things that's also driving all these other things. And so if we put lighting that would be somewhat like sunshine, but indoors, but we could do our normal things, that would be the great thing. Ideally, and what we've been working on is a light that has both blue, very short wavelength blue light, and longer wavelength yellow, both inside of a white light, and it switches between those. But it switches between them in a way that our cells that communicate with our mood and our circadian rhythms, they can see these changes in the color, but we don't. But our conscious vision doesn't see them. And so they look kind of like regular light bulbs, but inside they're actually driving very robustly the mechanisms in our visual system that have all these great effects.
Well, I start by talking about circadian photoentrainment, which is the process of how we set our internal biological clock to the external light-dark cycle, and how as the sun rises and sets, you know, the total amount of light changes, and that's one thing that's been studied a lot. But the color of the light actually changes as well, and that's what this circuit that I'm studying is involved in. The idea is if you think of a picture of a sunset, this is a color vision circuit. It's not for seeing the colors of the sunset, but for using the colors to tell the time of day. Oh, definitely one thing we're working on is more studies about how the lights affect our circadian rhythms, how we can slightly alter the parameters to better entrain your circadian rhythms. And then from just the anatomy and the retinal circuitry side, the S-cone circuits, we know so little about them. That's why it was so easy to find just one new S-cone cell. And in the process, we found that there's a few other cells that are also receiving this blue cone input and potentially more uses for color vision, not for color perception, but for other purposes. These cells are projecting to other areas in the brain, doing unknown functions, and we're very excited to figure out what those cells are doing and how it's relevant for our vision.